Hey guys, in this video, I will show you guys how to properly do UV mapping in Blockbench under 4 minutes. Blockbench does not really have a great UV mapping tool, so if you want to turn your textures from this messy file into this organized texture file, then stay tuned and let's get into the tutorial. First off, head into your plugin list by clicking on File, then clicking on Plugins at the bottom. Search for the mTools plugin made by Malik123. It gives you a ton of more features into Blockbench, but for now, we would only be focusing on the UV mapping features. Click on Install, and it should be done in a couple of seconds. Now, you have a better UV mapping tool in Blockbench. Onto a model. Here, we have a head model with the texture file generated by Blockbench Auto UV Map. It seems decent, but if you look closely, there are faces that are too slanted or disorganized. To fix this, make sure you are in the edit mode, then select the face tool. Select the faces that you want to be together. Now, if you have a number pad, press 6 on it to put the view mode on front orthographic view. This is important as this removes the aspect of perspective. Now, right-click on the mesh. Hover on to the mTools option, then to UV mapping. Then click on Project from View. Then you would have made an organized UV map of the front face. Zooming in and out will change the size of the UV map respectively. Once you are satisfied with the size, make sure to not change the zoom until you finish UV mapping the mesh. In terms of how to organize the UV maps, it is up to you and how you work on your models. I do reference old PS1 textures when organizing my UV maps, so if you like the sound of that, you can find references of it all around the internet. I recommend that you play with the UV mapping tools first before applying it onto your models. Make sure that you are familiar enough with it. If you don't have a number pad, you can access it using the gizmo on the bottom right of the screen. The number pad just puts the view into the different directions in orthographic view. After playing with it, I am sure that you guys would get the hang of it. That's all for this tutorial, and I hope that it would help you guys with making your models.